Welcome back to the Spring Boot tutorial. Before this, Spring have its own walkthrough authorization server module, then it's deprecated. But we have other options that have already been established, like Glue and Keycloak. For this tutorial, we will use Keycloak as an authorization server, since it's recommended by Spring when the walkthrough support ends in Spring version 2.4.0. We will use Spring Boot and PostgreSQL as resources server. This tutorial is divided into several steps. Step number 1, set up Keycloak authorization server. Step number 2, create Spring Boot application. Step number 3, configure Spring security and walkthrough. Step number 4, create Spring data entity, repository, service and REST controller. Step number 5, run and test using Postman. Step number 1, set up Keycloak authorization server. Set up Keycloak. We will use a standalone Keycloak server that can be downloaded from the official Keycloak download. Download the latest Keycloak server. For this time, we will use version 17.0.1. Extract to your project directory. Then open the terminal or command line. Then go to the Keycloak directory. Now edit the configuration file to use the PostgreSQL database. Uncomment the DB username, and DB URL. Then give them your PostgreSQL configuration parameters. Save this file, then go to the PostgreSQL console. Next, type this command for creating a new user with a password, then give access for creating the database. Quit PostgreSQL console. Then log in again using the new user that was previously created. Type these commands to create a new database. Then give that new user privilege to the new database, then quit the PostgreSQL console. Run and configure Keycloak. To run Keycloak as standalone server, go to the bin directory to run the Keycloak server. In your browser, then go to http localhost 8080. Fill in the admin username, password, and password confirmation, then click the Create button. Click the Administration Console button, then log in using the previously created username and password. And here the Keycloak admin dashboard with the default realm is master. To create a new realm, click the drop-down of the master menu in the left menu, then click add realm. Fill in the name and enable it on, then click the create button. Now the new realm is created and the dashboard changed to the new realm. Next, create the new client by clicking the Clients menu on the left. Click the Create button at the top right of the Clients table. Fill in the required fields such as Client ID, Client Protocol, and Root URL, then click the Save button. In the client settings, leave everything as default except the valid redirect URL. Fill with your Spring Boot Resources Server URL with an asterisk. Next, create a new role by clicking on the Roles menu on the left. Click the Add Role button in the top right of the Roles table. Fill the role name, then click the Save button, and it will be redirected to the role details. Next, click the Users menu on the bottom left menu. Click the Add User button, then fill all required fields as below. Click the Save button and it will be redirected to the User Details page. Click the Role Mappings tab, then choose User in the available roles. Then click Add Selected. Now the user will appear in the roles in the Role tab. Next, on the User Details page, click the Credentials tab, then fill the password and password confirmation fields with your password. Make temporary switch is off, otherwise it will be required to reset the password before using it. And click the Set Password button. Now the key lock and users is ready to use. We can test to get the token using Postman. In the Postman, make a post request with URL localhost 8080 realms jammer protocol OpenID dash connect token. Fill the request body, this x www form URL encoded fields. Client ID, username, password, and grant type. Make sure grant type is password. Then click the Send button. And you will see this Postman response from the Keycloak server that return the access token expires in refresh expire in refresh token. Token type is bearer, not before policy, session state and scope. Step number 2, create Spring Boot application. To generate a Spring Boot starter application and Spring Boot auth to resources server, go to Spring Initializer. Start Spring IO. Choose Maven Projects, Java Language, Spring Boot version 2.6.5 or stable version. In the project's metadata, create your own group or default package. Our using ComJamware. Artifact is JMAP, and the name same with artifact. Packaging is jar and Java versions is 11. In dependencies, choose web, auth, resources server, Spring security, PostgreSQL driver, and Spring data GPA. Click the Generate button to download the initial Spring Boot projects, then extract it to your Spring Boot projects folder. Open the Spring Boot application projects using your IDE, NetBeans, IntelliJ, IDE, Eclipse, or VS Code. We are using IntelliJ. Next, open and edit POM XML, then at least dependency. Reload Maven changes to download and install the newly added dependency. Step number 3. Configure Spring Security and OAuth 2. We will use application YML instead of the application properties file. For that, rename the application properties file to the application YML. Then replace or add these lines of YML configurations, which are server port, PostgreSQL connection, and Spring Security OAuth 2 resource server. As you can see, we are using port 8083 to run this Spring Boot resources server because the default port 8080 is used by KeyClock standalone server. We need to create database for this resources server. For that, enter the PostgreSQL console from the terminal. Tap these commands to create a new database. Then give user privilege to the new database, then quit the PostgreSQL console. To find out KeyClock GWT issuer UR and JWK set URI, you can check it using Postman to this URL. Next, we need to add Spring Security config by creating a new package comjammer jamapp config and a file security config jaffer inside that package. Replace the codes in this file with these codes. The model mapper injects into this configuration because we will use in entity to DTO converter. The Spring Security is securing API boards endpoints with authority user or role user that previously created in KeyClock. Also configure auth resources server and GWT S tokens that will be used when the secure endpoint is accessed. Step number 4. Create Spring Data Entity Repository Service and REST Controller. Before creating an entity or models that we use in Spring Boot or OAuth 2 Resources Server, create a new package with the name comjammer jamapp entity and a Java file with the name bird.java. Replace all Java codes with this. If you want less codes for entity or model class, you can use Lombok. Next, before creating a repository that will be used by service or controller, create a new package with the name comjammer jamapp repository and a Java interface file with the name bird repository Java. Replace all Java interface codes with this. This repository is flexible because we just need to get a list from the model. Next, create a comjammer jamapp service package. and add interface file, a board surface Java, and a class file board surface implementation Java. Replace all codes in board surface impl Java with this. Replace all codes in iBoard surface Java with this. Next, create a new REST controller by creating a new package first. Comjml jmap controller. And then a class file board controller Java. Replace all codes in board controller Java with this. Also, create a DTO file by creating a new package first, comjml jmap DTO. Then a class file board DTO Java. Then replace all codes with this. This REST controller mapping to the board list results to the secure API board's endpoints. The model result is converted to the JSON DTO before turning to the REST response. Step number 5. Run and test using Postman. Before running this Spring Boot Wildfoot server, make sure the KeyClock standalone authorization server is running. Or if not, type this command in the bin directory /kc.sh /start-dev. To run Spring Boot OAuth resource server, simply type this command. After running the Spring Boot application, load this dummy data to the database. Next, open the Postman, then get the GET request to localhost 8083 API boards. That request should respond with status 401 on unauthorized. To make an authorized request, first, we need to get the token from the KeyClock by making a new Postman request with post method and URL. When hitting the send button, it should respond to the GW token like this. Just copy the access token value to the get board's request headers. And don't forget to add prefix bearer before the GWT token. When hit the send button, it should respond to the JSON array like this. That is Spring Boot Security, PostgreSQL, and KeyClock REST API OAuth 2. You can get the full source code and the article in the description below. Thank you.